Have you ever wanted to turn an object invisible? Yeah, me too. Turns out if you can bring the background to the foreground, well then you can give the optical illusion of an object being invisible. And if you like this simple concept, then you're gonna love today's episode, because I'm gonna use some computer software to bring the background to the foreground to give you real invisibility. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science. Now today's topic, invisibility. Now what you just saw was a trick of me playing with the perspective of the camera, and that got me thinking. What if I gave you guys a sneak peek on something my Impossible Science team invented? The inside scoop on something I've never shared before. See, most people think of invisibility as an object you just can't see, but it's a little bit more complicated than that. If you want to make an object invisible, just remember it's not about the object. See, we see objects because light reflects off their surface and it bounces back to our eyes. When the reflected light off that object is blocked or bent away, we cannot see that object. This is why if you have an opaque object in front of you, you cannot see immediately behind it, because the light from the background is being stopped by the obstruction. However, if we can make the light from the background still reach our eye by bending it around the obstruction, in this case with mirrors, we would make that obstruction invisible. So the secret to making an object invisible is really about seeing the background. Now that we understand invisibility, let's put this theory of the background in the foreground in action. And we can do it with projection mapping. Projection mapping is a special technology used in video projection to make brilliant visuals. The downside is you can only see these visuals from one angle. When we want to make sure everyone can enjoy Impossible Science exhibits, we searched for a technology that would allow you to experience it no matter your height. But because this technology didn't exist, we created it. So what you're about to see is extremely unique. This is our prototype of
adaptive projection mapping.
To create this experiment, three important things had to come into play. First, the software. Daniel Erbach, Eric Trice, and I wrote and designed the software from scratch. It uses computer vision to tell the computer where the audience member is viewing this experiment from, and the software also allows us to remove the object from that point of view. The camera. Our camera is able to identify where someone's eyes would be. Next, the computer calculated and created an image of what our cove would look like if it were empty from that audience member's height and point of view. Then, the structure. We created the invisibility cove and the blocks we're using with a 3D printer, so we know the exact sizes of everything in the cove. I love those things. Finally, warped images. Our software places the warped distorted image in the perfect position so that we can turn those 3D printed shapes invisible by bringing the background image forward, disguising the blocks in all the right places, making sure that the background all still lines up. Projection mapping plus camera plus warped images over objects. This is adaptive projection mapping at its finest.
Now you can see that there's the background is really just a projection, right? And these colors are coming from the projector. So this blue block, you can actually see it on my hand. See how those lines match up? These are projection mapped to this blue block. This blue block does not have any color to it. It's just white in the right spot. So let's dim the lights. Can't wait for this one.
And this is what it looks like to be invisible. Now, even if I move back and forth, it's staying invisible. The objects are not going anywhere. The projection is just adapting to where I am. And so it's trying to keep the blocks invisible to my eyes. Let's try to see if we can make the pyramid vanish. Isn't that great? If we didn't know that pyramid was there from the beginning, we wouldn't have seen that. Even if I move back and forth, this projection is adapting to the shape and the perspective that I'm looking at. The background is now in the foreground and it's invisible. I would say this is a great proof of concept.
Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed turning an object invisible by bringing the background to the foreground. If you enjoy just making the impossible topic possible, make sure you let me know. Click the like button, share the video with your friends. And if you have any questions, make sure you make them in the comments below. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.